Well, well. If it isn't the Intercontinental Champion. I remember my first IC title, but barely. Because I've had so many.
Losing your memory in your old age, huh? So sad.
Wow. Locke's got jokes. And I was just about to teach you everything I know about being the Intercontinental Champ.
Enlighten me.
To be a true Intercontinental Champion requires a truly intercontinental skill set with mastery of styles from all over the world.
And your intercontinental specialty is British, Japanese, Lucha, Cleveland?
No, no, no. I am the greatest French-style wrestler of all time, of course. A style defined by the element of surprise, or as the French say, surprise, with a z, which they stole from me.
Are you sure about that?
My wife is French, so I'd know. But enough spelling talk. Let me show you what the Intercontinental Championship is all about. In the ring, for your title, what do you say?
Sure, but I've got more important business first. I've already got a cage match title defense lined up.
Well, bonne chance, as the French would say. Break a leg, or two.
An impressive win over Madcap Moss.
Here comes the man with a shot to the back.
What the heck is he doing out here?
And now the Miz is asking for the cage to be lowered down. This is absolute mayhem.
The champion just survived a cage match, and now he's dealing with this?
The champ's doing his best to battle back, but Miz has played the element of surprise to perfection. Can the champion capitalize on this opening?
Low blow from the Miz.
The most unpredictable man in sports entertainment has struck again.
And again, and again, and again. Talk about a long night for the Intercontinental Champion. This is brutal.
Intercontinental Champions teamed up with a North of the Border superstar tonight for a mixed tag team match against WWE's marquee French couple, Miz and Maryse.
Hold on, since when are the Miz and Maryse French?
I wouldn't second guess Miz, Saxton. Not when it comes to maneuvering his way to another Intercontinental title. Watch and learn.
Kick to the back.
Big elbow drop.
Getting a little battered now.
Incoming. Big time powerbomb.
You can see the dismay on the face of the Miz.
Not looking so awesome for Miz here.
Hit the mark with that one.
Even more out of his opponent. Just like the Miz to unnecessarily gloat.
No, oh, I can't see what you're complaining about, Saxton. I'm blinded by the Miz's star power.
He's getting fired up now, really feeding off this crowd.
Okay, already, we get it. Stop looking for adulation from the crowd and get back into the fight. Uh-oh, look at what are they gonna do? Oh, right to the face!
Right to the back of the neck!
And again!
Enough!
That's just a beatdown. And Miz got really caught by what would be a crucial bit of offense there.
Yeah, this is exactly why constant, frequent tags are so important in a match like this, to keep fresh. That powerbomb was absolutely worthy of both halves of its name.
Start counting, Saxton.
One, two, three.
We could be here all day. Power.
I think you're right. Rotating vertical suplex. Nicely done. gosh. That'll stop anybody.
Oh, ouch. The upper hand now belongs to Locke.
The Locke isn't holding anything back.
Oh, my, what a splash.
Oh, ran him there.
Now Miz looking for some momentum.
Also, a good chance for Miz to gain his winsome.
And some effective offense with that one.
Right across the larynx.
We're undoubtedly nearing the end.
This is getting hard to watch, guys. We might need to stop this one.
Chops in another. Here they come, over and over.
And there's more. Wow, that's double clothesline too.
And more attacks to his core could hinder his offense.
Ooh, what a forearm claw.
Vicious, downright savage club right there.
Dragon screw. Double axe handle. Bam!
Beautiful shot block. Just hot shot it to the outside.
What could Josie be looking for?
From the top! Whoa, what a landing! Just crashing down with high impact.
And Josie got bottled up there.
Oh man, meeting the barricade. Top rope, here we go.
Shinbreaker.
Not done yet.
Oh, this will tear your knee apart.
And Maurice can't stop any offense coming her way.
Maurice needs to find an opening fast.
Ooh, she just turned it around. Oh, my God.
Pendulum back for the pin and the win.
Yes. Still hit with a quick kick out.
She kicked out there, but I don't know how much more she can take.
Oh, Jane creates an opportunity. Looking worse for wear in the corner.
What's Josie gonna do?
Double down! Exclamation delivered by Josie.
Cover!
Wrestling gods have truly blessed this union. I fully expect to see more showings like this going forward from this duo.
Congratulations on nothing. That win was completely meaningless. What matters is that I still have an IC title shot. Care to make it French rules?
Here we go. What does that even mean?
It's the highest form of unpredictable surprise-based sports entertainment. A proper cage match with escape-only rules. Are you intercontinental enough to handle it?
Call it whatever you want, Miz. It's clearly just a pathetic attempt to find an advantage that you will desperately need. Bad news, though? I'm keeping this intercontinental title no matter what fake French surprise you have planned.
Bad news? No way! I'm clearly in your head, which is the best news. Say au revoir to your championship.
The following is a steel cage match. And is
match for the WWE Intercontinental Championship.
Take a good look at the new face of WWE. It's The Lock.
For the Intercontinental Champ, Corey.
Patience, Saxton, which is something you need as well as The Lock if he wants to add to his title collection.
Social media buzzing as it always does when this competitor defends his title. This is gonna be good.
Face throughout his career, his greatest opponent is the rule book.
Someone who will do anything necessary to win and, of course, protect his status.
Because everything he touches turns to gold. An A-lister is must-see all day, every day.
Introducing the challenger from Hollywood, California, weighing in at 221 pounds, The Miz! And his opponent from New York, weighing in at 252 pounds, he is the WWE Intercontinental Champion, The Superstar!
The Intercontinental Championship, one of the most coveted titles in all of WWE. Ladies and gentlemen, get ready for the dramatic conclusion to the head-spinning saga between the defending Intercontinental Champion and The Miz.
That's right, Michael. The Lock will defend his Intercontinental title against The Miz in a French rules cage match where the first competitor to escape the cage will walk away with the IC title.
Sit back, butter your baguettes, and enjoy two of the best in the business with the premium live event.
Stomp after stomp.
The challenger's looking shaken.
Tossed into the corner. Charging up the arm. And
there's the clothesline.
Making the climb up the cage. Here he goes.
And every inch climbed puts you in a more perilous position.
Yeah. He's made it to the top, but can he finish? And now he's starting to make his way up the cage. He's nearly there. Just a few more sure-footed steps, and he's victorious.
Looks like he's having trouble getting that other leg over.
Scores the reversal on Miz. He's working toward making his escape. He can almost taste the win in this cage match.
He doesn't want to spend too much time up there. Very precarious position here. Gotta wonder if the stamina is there to make it all the way.
Able to stop him here. Really showing his... battling on the top. Down they go. He takes a painful fall for the cage.
Yeah, he's going to have to try something else now.
The sprint up the cage is on.
Crashing a long way down. Oh, no. He comes off the cage and lands right back in the ring.
Oh, that could not have felt good.
The challenger not looking good right now.
The steel cage is just as punishing as your opponent, Cole.
He's got him scouted.
Touch.
Nasty. Oh, my, what a splash. Kick to the gut.
Ooh, brutal forearm.
Assaulting the knee with purpose.
Start counting, Saxton.
One, two, three.
We could be here all day.
Power.
I think you're right.
Rotating vertical suplex. Nicely done.
From the middle rope.
And the lock has picked up the pace.
Not an A-list performance here from Miz.
Way to steer clear.
Big knockdown. Oh, looking for it. Back body drop. And comes up short there. The Miz hot dogging right now. Well, that's nothing new.
Incredible guts to make this climb.
Trying desperately to escape.
Oh! Great counter by the Miz. Catches nothing but air. Kick to the midsection. Oh, this is so much fun to watch. Revolution's in the spinning powerbomb.
A championship level move. Better be quick about it. Not much time to get over.
At the top, but he still has a way to go to end this. And as he continues to climb the side of the cage, you have to think his confidence is starting to build.
Fought so hard to be in this position, but he's only halfway to victory. Above the competition.
Here is your winner, and still WWE Intercontinental Champion, the Superstar.
No other way to put it, guys. That was kind of a butt kicking.
Never a doubt. Barely a moment's suspense. This one was about as lopsided as they come.
It's a superstar who's a lock to be on top of WWE for years to come.
The following contest is a steel cage match. Making his way to the ring from New York, weighing in at 252 pounds, the WWE Intercontinental Champion, the Superstar.
The Intercontinental Champion hasn't made too many entrances in his WWE career, but he seems to be getting the hang of it.
He seems to be getting the hang of a lot of things, like winning. Let's see if he can keep the train rolling here tonight. He cannot be frozen in awe. Must be prepared to slay the giant.
Coming his way.
Yeah, Locke is proving hard to keep up with. Sharp jab. Series of strikes to the back.
Clubbing blows. Now he's been put on the defensive.
He's been placed in the corner now.
And Andre expected that.
Perhaps thinking about what to do next here.
Turning the throat there.
Oh, man! Ouch.
Slips out of the way.
Set him up.
Double axe handle. Oof. Set up in the corner of the ring.
Guys, I can't think of a worse place for him to be.
All the way up top. Nasty arm drag. He's struggling a bit here.
This match has been so back and forth. I think it could still go either way.
Devastating kick.
Stomp after stomp after stomp.
And Locke got turned around there.
He grew tired of his smug attitude. They're about to try to exit out the cage door.
And Andre lining it up.
Supersized elbow drop.
That's it. The Giant just ended things. Heading up and maybe heading out.
Safe being up there. And these two superstars now battling at the top of the cage.
I know they say it's lonely at the top, but things are looking a little too crowded up there for my comfort level.
Battling on the top.
Oh, back landing.
And a hellacious fall from the cage.
Yeah, he's gonna have to try something else now.
Making the big climb towards victory.
And now he's at an impasse at the top of the cage. He's working toward making his escape. He can almost taste the win in this cage match.
The longer he's up there, the more fear starts to seep into the mind.
Wanted to talk, right? What's up?
I've been thinking back on my own career lately, and I realized a lot of my success can be credited to the factions I was a part of, both off screen and on. Just like you, I was strong-willed and independent. But in WWE, you often find yourself needing backup. The other members of the clique and DX also push each other to be better.
What are you getting at?
Two prominent superstars have approached management with the idea of building a faction around you, and the brass thinks it's a good idea.
Is this because of the LA Live event?
It's not about what happened in LA.
I promise, if I get the opportunity to headline again, I'll do everything in my power to make sure it's standing room only.
Sure, whatever. But this faction stuff has nothing to do with that. It's all about accelerating your rise to the top. And I think it says a lot that a couple of heavy hitters came to us wanting to build something around you. So I'll say it again. You just need to play ball here and trust the process.
Okay, but if I do this, I see it as a good opportunity to freshen up my look. So no more lock gear, okay?
If that's what it takes to get this done, then fine.
Okay, then I'm on board. So who approached you about this? What are my options?
The two superstars who want to recruit you are MVP and Randy Orton. Go talk to them, hear what they have to say, and decide what's best for your career.
Glad we could finally talk, especially since you might be hearing some big promises from guys like MVP. But let's cut to the chase. What has he really accomplished?
A lot, actually. He's been a success both inside the ring and outside guiding the Hurt Business.
Sounds like MVP's gotten to you already. But I know he's a big talker, which is about all he can do these days. Unlike me.
So, why are you getting involved with all this faction stuff?
I enjoyed what I had in RK-Bro, and it got me thinking about my start in WWE, when I was a part of one of the greatest factions of all time, Evolution. I want to add to my legacy by building an even better version.
Interesting. So where do I fit in?
I'll be the veteran leader, the Triple H type. And I see the Lock and the Phenom role that I held. You're not the guy yet, but with my help, you will be.
I seem to recall that you and Evolution didn't end on the best terms.
You don't need to worry about that. With me in charge, it will be different. And when the time's right, I'll pass the torch to you and you'll become world champion, just like I did.
When will that be?
I can't make any promises. Ultimately, it's up to you. Ball's in your court now. Let me know what you want to do.
Intercontinental champion, The Lock. It's a pleasure, man. I've enjoyed watching you tear it up so far on Raw. And they weren't wrong with all that hype, which is why I wanted to talk to you. I'm relaunching the Hurt Business, and I want you to be the centerpiece, the new CEO.
The last version had issues. I couldn't keep track from one week to the next if you were together, broken up, or who was even in the group.
You're not wrong, which is why I am going to do it right this time. And that starts with you. I mean, look at what I did for Bobby Lashley. I helped elevate him to become WWE champion. And I can do the same thing for you, but faster. Since, let's be honest, Bobby was a bit of a rehabilitation project, but you're ready for prime time.
So, who else do you have in mind for the group?
I'm reviewing a lot of top candidates, but don't worry about that. No matter who else joins, The Lock is going to be the guy, the focus of the group. Every decision the Hurt Business makes will be to further your individual success first.
That all sounds good. Assuming you're not just saying all this to get me on board.
I'm not. Trust me. I see big things in you. So what do you think? You ready to make the best decision of your life?
I still need more time to decide.
I totally get it. Think it over and do what's best for you. Hopefully, that means joining my side.
I'll let you know.
Did you make up your mind about joining me?
Yeah, I'm ready to be a part of Evolution.
Good. You made the right call. I'm extremely confident in your abilities, but I want to give you a crash course in doing things the Evolution way. Meet me at the Performance Center tomorrow, and don't be late.
I'll be there.
That hold now. Ah. Okay, break.
Joining Evolution feels like a turning point in my career. I mean, everything before this felt big, but now it really seems like I'm on my way to the top.
But do you think Randy Orton will be willing to share the spotlight with you? Can you trust him?
I was skeptical of all this at first, but I'm trying my best to trust the process. Which is tough, since I know Randy's not always been the most straight-up guy, but I think he really wants to do this the right way. And that means stepping aside when the time's right and giving me the spotlight.
Any clue who else will be joining this new Evolution?
Randy hasn't told me anything. I guess we'll all find out together.
Someone is arriving in style. Any idea who this could be?
I'm not sure. As far as I know, all the VIPs are already here.
Interesting. What's this all about?
We've seen these two team before, but I thought it was just a one-time thing.
We heard the rumors surrounding Randy Orton. This must be the debut of his newly reformed Evolution.
Let's go. Led by Orton, Evolutionists here on Raw, and they look ready to dominate.
I'm having flashbacks to 20 years ago.